Well, hello, Dancer here in Microsoft Flight Simulator 2020. Yeah. Over here, we are now going to make a little trip from the airfield, Aggertsdale, to Heuven. And on our way, we will take a look at the Castle Neuschwanstein. But because these two airfields are green fields, which means they have no tower, no ATC, air traffic control. So I only have to announce myself on the radio to let the other pilots in the area know what my intentions are, like who I am, where I am, and what I want to do. So if I talk radio telephony, it's only because of the other pilots in the area. Cool. So, let's start up my plane. Oh my god. These two guys over here are standing on the same place. Huh. I guess it's an glitch in the matrix of Flight Simulator 2020?
Weird.
Anyway, let's make this trip now. I hope this truck won't interfere when I'm over there as well. Okay, let's check. Nav lights on, taxi lights on. Beacon lights on, strobe lights later. Flaps on. Lower some flaps. Okay. Aggertsdale traffic, flight 785, test now 172, taxiing to holding point runway 36. Planes in such a small airfield. And another glitch in the matrix of Flight Simulator 2020. A spike. The funny point is when I fly to it, it disappears. Let's make a steep turn over here on such a small field. Made it. Okay, let's have a better view. Let's see. Taxi lights off, landing lights on, and now also the strobe lights. Let's get the jokes back. Aggertsdale traffic. Flight 785, Cessna 172 is taking off runway 36. Rotate.
flaps up. Heading for waypoint 1. Arkansas traffic, flight 785, Techno 172 is leaving the circuit. Alrighty, we are up in the air. Such a nice simulator. To be honest, when I fly in Microsoft Flight Simulator 2020 and I look at the scenery and all the graphics and I compare this with Prepare 3D 4.5, man, what a difference. What you see over here is standard scenery. But when you look at this in Prepare 3D, day and night difference. So I like to fly in VFR, visual flight rules. Low and slow, which means that I can enjoy the scenery and the area much better when you are flying very high in IFR. Instrument flight. So this is what I like the most from a flight simulator, and that's why I see this flight sim as a eye candy flight sim. Yeah. All right. I just passed waypoint 1, and I'm now heading for waypoint 2. Over here, this is my GPS. TomTom in the sky. I'm flying for 1.1 to 1.2, and this is my flight plan on my way to Castle Neuschwanstein, the white fairy tale castle. Let's see how this will look like in the morning at 9:15, which you can see over here, a little clock. Okay, let's gain some height. In front of us is this hill, and I'm not going to fly over it, I'm going to fly around it, left. Because I like to enjoy the scenery. Oh, my window is a little bit dirty. Oh, but the funny part is when I go to the passenger side here and look through the window, it's much cleaner. Anyway, so when I fly over this little village here on our left, Bertach village, I was just wondering, there also live a girl up here called Heidi in the south of Germany? It wouldn't surprise me. Anyway, let's focus again on our flight plan. So this castle, this fairy tale castle, is behind this hill, these hills. Oh, did I mention that I like the scenery a lot in this flight sim? Oh, by the way, if you catch me making a mistake, too bad. I'm still learning. And this was a message to all other flight sim enthusiasts who are watching me doing this video with very sharp eyes. Is he doing everything correct? Does he not make any mistakes? I'm still learning, as I mentioned before. And when you watch this video, you also notice that when I turn my head, it looks almost like the real deal. That's because I'm using a Track IR system. You can Google it to figure out what it actually does. In the flight sim, I don't have to change views to the right or the left with the button on my yoke. No, I can just do it by turning my head, like in real life. It feels more natural. That's why I only need one monitor. Or when I fly in virtual reality, then you are totally inside the simulator. That's another story. All right. Just passed waypoint 3, and I'm now going to waypoint. It's called in Dutch ingang, which means entrance. And what do I mean by that? I go to a waypoint. When I enter it, I am in the direction of my flight, in the right direction to pass the castle, so we can have a nice view from the outside. Oh yeah. Lens flares in the flight sim. God, so good. So, for me there are two challenges. First, to fly over the castle and don't hit one of the hills, and then the landing. But when we come to the landing, I'll explain why this is a little bit different, because the airfield is between two hills in the valley, so you have to make a turn to create some speed. But that's for later time in this video. Now let's focus on the castle, fairy tale castle. It looks so real. So nice. South of Germany. Yeah. Over here is also an airfield. You can't hardly see it. It is only created for gliders, engine-less planes. Okay. Let's focus on our castle. There. Like I said, this trip has two challenges. Get as close as possible to the castle without hitting the surrounding hills, and then the landing later on. Okay, let's focus. Ooh, that was close. But we passed it. Now let's focus on the valley where I will land. First of all, I have to climb over this hill on my left. A little bit more power. So, my wheel didn't kiss the tops of the trees this time. Right in front of us is this little airfield with the grass strip instead of a asphalt runway called Heuven. And actually it's here. I can land also from here, but I also need to build some speed. That's why I make a circle around it between the two hills, like the hill over here and the hill over there. So I'll make a turn here, go down and try to land as low as I can. Oh, wir hatten den Urgetret, ist es wirklich schon so spät? Ja, wir sind wieder da. Heuven traffic flight 785 is just now 172, 2 minutes. North of airfield to land for runway 22 at 4,000 feet. Flaps down. Throttle down. Yeah, here on my left. Alright, and now focus on the two turns of the circuit. Heuven traffic, flight 785, test now 172, joining left hand, circuit downwind, runway 22. and I'm giving myself now a little bit more space to make the turn correctly. Oh, my shadow. So you guys are now following me doing this landing live. More flaps down. Driven traffic, flight 785 on final. Touchdown! Heuven traffic, flight 785, Cessna 172, runway vacated, taxi to parking area. Let's see if someone is marshalling me today. Oh yeah, there's guy waiting for me, marshalling me. So then I know where to stop on this airfield. To the left. Right, okay, almost done. Okay, everybody, that's it. I hope you like my Tesla trip. Have a nice day.